Hello everyone, this is Moni from PTE Magic, and I recently completed a mock test on Pearson's website. This is the 2-hour new mock test, which will also come out in the real test after the 16th of November. And as you can see here, I got 90 all bands for all 4 skills, including listening, reading, speaking, and writing. And so in today's video, I'm going to show you how I did this mock test, which is mock test B. You can get this mock test yourself on your PTE account, the same account that you use to book the test. This is also the official mock test from Pearson. So they use the same marking algorithm, which is from the actual exam. Extroverts tend to move quickly and try to influence situations directly, while introverts give themselves time to develop their insights before exposing them to the world. Extroverts are happy making decisions in the thick of events, while introverts want to reflect before taking action. Extroverts tend to move quickly and try to influence situations directly, while introverts give themselves time to develop their insights before exposing them to the world. Extroverts are happy making decisions in the thick of events, while introverts want to reflect before taking action. The purpose of informative speech is to provide interesting, useful, and unique information to your audience. By dedicating yourself to the goals of providing information and appealing to your audience, you can take a positive step toward succeeding in your efforts as an informative speaker. The purpose of the informative speech is to provide interesting, useful, and unique information to your audience. By dedicating yourself to the goals of providing information and appealing to your audience, you can take a positive step towards succeeding in your efforts as an informative speaker. Most of us spend on average 1,800 hours per year in our jobs and will work for about 40 years before retirement. When you consider the amount of time spent in the office, you soon realize how important it is to feel a sense of achievement at the end of the day, rather than just meeting financial objectives. Most of us spend on average 1,800 hours per year in our jobs and will work for about 40 years before retirement. When you consider the amount of time spent in the office, you soon realize how important it is to feel a sense of achievement at the end of the day, rather than just meeting financial objectives. Quite obviously, a significant rise in the number of people in a given area or country will affect the demand for a whole host of goods and services. Note that a change in the structure of the population will increase the demand for some goods but reduce the demand for others. Quite obviously, a significant rise in the number of people in a given area or country will affect the demand for a whole host of goods and services. Note that a change in the structure of the population will increase the demand for some goods but reduce the demand for others. With the population of only just over 30 million living in the world's second largest country, Canada is justly renowned for vast tracts of wilderness, troubled by population either from industry or from intensive farming methods. A major conservation issue is the battle to stop the logging of virgin forest in northern Ontario and on the west coast. Okay, population, wilderness, untroubled, renowned conservation issue. With the population of only just over 30 million living in the world's second largest country, Canada is justly renowned for vast tracts of wilderness untroubled by population either from industry or from intensive farming methods. A major conservation issue is the battle to stop the logging of virgin forest in northern Ontario and on the west coast. Yet this landscape, which appeared so alien and confronting to the white settlers and explorers, had been home for thousands of years to Indigenous Australians, for whom the plains, ranges, and deserts were a sustaining spiritual and integral part of their existence. Yet this landscape, which appeared so alien and confronting to the white settlers and explorers, had been home for thousands, ranges, deserts, Yet this landscape, which appeared so alien and confronting to the white settlers and explorers, had been home for thousands of years to Indigenous Australians, for whom the plains, ranges, and deserts were a sustaining spiritual and integral part of their existence. The interludes, which break up the game play action, and which, because they can be made to a higher level of animation, often provide the most visually arresting sequences of a game, combined with the taste for bizarrely complicated recursive plots and long sequences of wordy explicatory dialogue, this turns the games into a bit of a drag. The interludes, which break up the gameplay action and which, because they can be made to a higher level of animation, often provide the most visually arresting sequences of a game. The interludes, which break up the gameplay action and which, because they can be made to a higher level of animation, often provide the most visually arresting sequences of a game, combined with a taste for bizarrely complicated recursive plots and long sequences of wordy explicatory dialogue, this turns the games into a bit of a drag.
The elephant is the largest living land mammal.
The elephant is the largest living land mammal.
There are lots of opportunities to meet new people in this course.
There are lots of opportunities to meet new people in this course.
The computer crashed and I hadn't saved my work.
The computer crashed and I have not saved my work.
You must include your name and identity number on the registration form.
You must include your name and identity number in the registration form.
The main issue is to decide how we want to launch the new product.
The main issue is to decide how we want to launch the new product.
This paper is the best one to look at first.
These papers are the best one to look at first.
What's going on that can help patients leave their fears at the door?
What's going on that can help patients to leave their fears at the door?
Inflation rose by 2% over this time last year.
Inflation rose by 2% over this time last year.
Applicants for the course should preferably have a degree in English or journalism.
Applicants for this course will preferably have a degree in English or journalism.
After 1830, periodicals appeared in large numbers in America.
After 1830s, periodicals appear in large numbers in America.
Soil erosion can be caused by increased rainfall and changes in plant growth.
Swelling can be appeared in the plant growth. Missed that one. The last one is always the most difficult one. The bar chart below shows the reimbursement available for volunteers who incur expenses. As can be seen from the bar charts, the highest percentage can be seen in postage with around 39%, followed by others with around 20%. Also, the least of the reimbursement can be seen in uniform, which is around 15%. Other categories include phone calls with 19%, meals 18%, training 17%, and travel cost is the same as training, which is 17%. So in conclusion, most people incur expenses in postage. The bar chart below shows the education pace. As can be seen from the chart, doctoral degree has the highest median weekly earnings in 2007, which is $1,497, while has the minimum unemployment rate in 2007, which is 1.4%. On the other hand, associate degrees has the lowest earnings in 2007, which is $740, but the highest unemployment rate, which is 3%. Others include bachelor's degrees with 2.2% in unemployment rate and master's degrees with 1.8% unemployment rate. Okay, I was just like, spoke very quickly in that one. Okay, so you have, when you have something like this, there are so many words which will help us a lot because we just need to read them out. The diagram below shows the comparison of the fundamental needs model with Abraham Maslow's hierarchy of needs. It shows the three main ones, which is state of esteem needs, stimulation needs, and security needs. There are also five needs, which is self-actualization, self-esteem, belonging, safety, and physiological needs, which include food, water, shelter, and warmth. And this is also the basic needs for humanity. So in conclusion, all these needs are related to each other and also showing in creativity, respect, recognition, friends, family, and love, as well as freedom from fear.
Coming out of the 19th century with all that happened, and so quickly, some of these ideas, some of these theories, like thermodynamics and kinetic theory, they didn't blend the way they should have. Thermodynamics has its roots in matter, how material things respond to heat and temperature and so forth. The laws of thermodynamics were thought to be absolute. Now take kinetic theory. If matter consists of atoms in random motion, and that's what matter is, then you open up the possibility that there will be fluctuations in samples of matter such that the laws of thermodynamics can momentarily be violated. Are the laws of thermodynamics valid, absolute? Are they obeyed statistically? On average, they're obeyed, but they can be violated during unusual times, all right?
The lecturer cited, during the 19th century, there are ideas of thermodynamics and kinetic theory, which blend with each other. The thermodynamics is rooted in matters and the material thing which with heat and temperature. The law of thermodynamics is absolute. However, for kinetic, it's shown that if matter consists of atoms, then there are open possibilities of fluctuations in matter. And he also said that the law of thermodynamics can be violated during unusual time, and it can also be obeyed statistically.
What is the term for the money people pay to the government to support public services?
Welfare. Maybe subsidy.
What material is normally used to make windows and light bulbs?
Glass.
Who prepares and sells medicine in a shop or hospital?
Pharmacist.
Where on a college campus would a periodicals collection be located?
Library.
What is the inedible center of a peach, cherry, or grape called?
Seed.
To find a detailed topographical map of Africa, what kind of reference book would be best to use?
Atlas.
For many people, language acquisition starts at around about 12 months when kids say their first word, but don't forget the first year. That first year of life's very important as well, and indeed before you're born, remember, there are a couple of months before you're born when you're actually able to perceive in the womb something of the language that's around you. So language acquisition starts earlier than most people think. And it also ends later than most people think. When does child language acquisition stop? Well, in a sense, you know, we're all children. We stay being children all our lives. There's no obvious end point. For learning sounds, of course, there is, and for learning grammar, there is. But vocabulary, that goes on for the rest of our lives. A million or more words in English, and most of us only have a vocabulary of 50, 60, 70,000 words or whatever it is. And so there's always something more to learn. So remember that the two ends of child language acquisition are wider apart than some people think. And that means there's more scope for studying it than most people think.
In his book, The Man Who Mistook His Wife for a Hat and Other Clinical Tales, neurologist Oliver Sacks relates the tale of a medical student who one day woke up and found that his sense of smell was so acute that, like a dog, he could walk around identifying people, places, and things by his sense of smell. And what a wondrous experience it was. Like a visit to another world, he said. Now, normally, we humans don't have a sense of smell as acute as many other animals. We tend to rely more on what we see or hear to tell us about the world. Still, our sense of smell is powerful. Most of us can detect 10,000 different odors, from cigar smoke to a chlorinated swimming pool, from curry to a city sewer. And think about how a particular odor can instantly conjure up past memories. Maybe it's fresh-cut grass that makes you think of childhood summers, or baking bread that reminds you of a special holiday.
Experimental psychological research is conducted in a lab under controlled conditions. It attempts to rely solely on an application of research methods to understand behavior and mental processes. As an example of a psychological experiment, you might want to investigate people's perception of different tones. Specifically, you could ask the following question. Is it easier for people to discriminate one pair of tones from another depending on their frequency? To answer this, you would want to disprove the hypothesis that all tones are equally easy to discriminate.
Graham Greene may have inadvertently supplied one of the key phrases of the past 50 years in the title of his novel, A Burnt-Out Case. The image of a dead fire perfectly fit the psychological aftermath of long hours, dashed hopes, and depression. And while burnout is not a medical diagnosis, it describes a condition we all recognize, except perhaps in ourselves.
Well, the banana is the first cultivated fruit. It's one of the food items that literally brought people out of the jungle, out of their hunter-gatherer lifestyles, and was there at the dawn of agriculture, which is what helped force human beings into communities. It's really one of the things that helped invent human culture. It's about 7,000 years of history. And the banana, from its center of origin, which is believed to be Papua New Guinea, it spread out with people who traveled in boats across the Pacific into the mainland of Asia and all the way south to Australia, across Indonesia, Micronesia, and eventually they moved as far as Africa and even possibly to Ecuador, all in this time and all on paddled boats and wind-driven boats.
In the United States, the poet Walt Whitman published a work called Democratic Vistas. This was in 1871, and I quote from that work. He's talking here about the development of a program of culture drawn out, not for a single class alone, or for the parlors or lecture rooms, but with an eye to the practical life and to the West, the working man, the facts and forms and jack planes and engines, and of the broad range of the woman also, of the middle class and working strata, and with reference to the perfect equal quality of women and of a grand and powerful motherhood. So these ideas of the individual, the ordinary individual, as someone who has a right and a responsibility to an education, had begun clearly to emerge in the United States.
So starting with a question, why industrial cities matter? Well, in 1995 and 6, funded by the Joseph Rowntree Foundation, I did a study with a fellow researcher called The Slow Death of Great Cities. And that was because urban abandonment in America was happening on such a scale and causing such terror over here that when cities like Manchester and Newcastle started to show signs of empty properties emerging in their city streets, in their inner city streets, there was kind of quite serious panic. So that was my first exposure to what happens when cities start losing population in a significant way.
And we identified 15 priority projects which are supposed to be urgent and immediate needs of adaptation. And these projects, the first one is slightly being implemented, but there is so much bureaucracy behind the funding of that project that it still hasn't been implemented properly. So if these were urgent and immediate needs, then how come it's not being implemented on an urgent and immediate basis? Because the fund is not there. Even if the fund is there, some bureaucratic things are holding it behind. There are some of the funds, they say, like, you have to have certain infrastructures in place and certain things have to be in place for us to fund this additional climate change. But the funds are, what everyone says in these climate change conferences, are not enough. They're just not enough.
When I was 14 years old, a visionary visited my school. The man was a pioneer in new technologies, and he had come to announce how the world I was growing up in was on the verge of radical change. He brandished a VHS cassette and announced that television was going to be transformed forever. Using the power of VHS, everyone would make their own TV programs. Instead of accepting the bland output of comedy and drama from the existing networks, we would simply take control ourselves and become producers as well as consumers. TV stations were going to close, corporations would fold, and a new wave of creativity was about to be unleashed. For me, at that age, it seemed like impeccable logic, and the scenario he described seemed inevitable. Over the following years, it became clear that what he had predicted was certainly not coming true, and I began to think of him as an idiot.
The neuroendocrine system is under particular onslaught in our modern life. Not only does it serve as the conduit for our emotional life, but it is also under threat from our external environment. The amount of chemicals acting as so-called endocrine disruptors is going up by the day. These chemicals, which range from pesticides and herbicides to ingredients of plastics, which look chemically like some of the hormones in our bodies, can then bind to the receptor and cause a stimulation of the receptor, or block it so that the appropriate hormone cannot...
Logistics is really orchestrating what we now call globalization. Companies have outsourced and offshored many of their operations. In fact, some of their almost their entire operations. And what's come to be called supply chain management, which is the strategic end of this business, is what knits it all together. It is what makes sure that things turn up where they should be, when they should be. And by squeezing cost out of the system, you don't carry so much stock, you don't need to have the warehouses of old, and you can move things faster and...
River systems can be classified by their basic shapes. Young streams are generally straight, are in narrow, steep-sided valleys, and are often fast-flowing in a channel with many big rocks. Young streams have high gradients, meaning the elevation of the stream changes quickly with distance. Old rivers are in broad, flat valleys. They flow slowly and carry sand and mud. Old streams, like the lower part of the Mississippi River, have very low gradients. That is, the elevation changes very little over long distances.
Over half of patients had what we called the no symptoms, no asthma health belief. They thought about and managed their asthma as an acute episodic illness, the way someone would treat a cold or a flu. They felt when they had their wheezing or shortness of breath, that's when they had their asthma, and it made perfect sense for them to use their quick relief medicines and their chronic controller medicines then. But once they started feeling better, they felt there was no reason for using those medicines because they felt okay.
It is absolutely vital that you acknowledge all your sources.
In any written assignment, a detailed literature review is very important.
Control systems in manufacturing provide a high level of accuracy.